threat was also improved with additional information that was collected from member states. And we are here because the book was finalized and printed in 2017. What was the objective? The objective was basically to document lessons learned across the region, showing the effective implementation of this strategy as on combating trafficking in persons. We are also here to share the lessons learned with member states and relevant stakeholders with the aim of improving their capacity to respond to the crime on trafficking and persons. That is the picture of the strategy. Here we are trying to share the research and information. This is a very important priority and activity. Is to document and share best practice on trafficking in persons. What is it that the people are doing better that can actually be learned and be replicated? The output being best practices and lessons learned on trafficking in persons documented and shared among member states. That's why we are here, and also we will be distributing this booklet. What is the criteria that is used to make a story a lesson? We're saying here that the story is relevant to at least one of the strategic priority areas. And these priority areas, as I will be showing, there are about eight. We're trying to look at what member states have done on legislation and policy measures, on training for skills enhancement and capacity building, prevention and public awareness, raising that both the PS Samantha we're talking about, that is very, very important that people know about this issue. Victim support and witness protection, how do you treat the victims if they have been stolen, how do you repatriate them, and so on and so on. Coordination and regional cooperation, as well as the most important, research and information sharing and resource mobilization. The other criteria used is the possibility of deriving clear and helpful lessons, they are broadened them, from the actions of the parties involved, which include public sector organizations, law enforcement agencies, local non-governmental organizations, international organizations, as well as the private sector. And we are also looking at some element of innovativeness. An effective practice may show a new way of implementing program that is more effective or saves resources in preventing and combating trafficking persons. It's very, very important, as we know, instances. We cannot solve the problem with the same thinking that created them. So we have to innovate and see better ways of dealing with this issue. The time frame for this research was covered 2009 to 2016. Let's look at the legislation and policy measures lessons. While stakeholder consultation is critical to trafficking persons legislative policy development, and here we are looking at the consultation undertaken in developing principle and subordinate legislation on trafficking persons in the SADC region. And we'll start with Namibia's absence of specific tip law, not ideal, but not necessarily barrier. What this means is that it doesn't mean that if you don't have a standalone law, you cannot actually convict perpetrators. That's why they are giving an example that Namibia does not have standalone legacy on trafficking persons, but in 2015, a case of trafficking persons was convicted under the other pieces of legislation, leading to a cumulative sentence of 52 years that will run concurrently, and the accused will serve an effective 13 years in prison. That is to say, even though they did not have a standalone legislation, they looked in the penal code and whatever legal instruments they had to actually bring this perpetrator to book. South Africa takes stern action against abuse of ukuthwala, simply meaning to carry enclosure in Zulu. Story relates to a case of a 14-year-old girl from Eastern Cape who was forced into early marriage to a 32-year-old man, and this accused was convinced, dead, and sentenced to 22 years in jail for 3 counts of rape, trafficking in persons, and assault. And South Africa has incorporated the practice of ukuthwala in legislative instrument to show that the practice is not abused by traffickers. South Africa also has steep penalties imposed to deter traffickers. There's a case of a 62-year-old businessman convicted of trafficking in persons and rape. They are granted a 5 years in between 10 and 16 years from Mozambique and sexually assaulted them for 4 years between 2009-2012. And the men are accused sentenced to 8 life sentences not to be served concurrently. Co-accused from Mozambique received suspended sentence of 20 years and was ordered to immediately go back to Mozambique. Legislation and policy measures also have Tanzania hands down 8-year jail sentence on a trafficker case of an Indian national who settled in Namibia in 2010 and opened a dancing and nightclub. Employed 22 young girls from India in Nepal and deceived them using prospects of decent employment. The magistrate ordered asset seizure, 3 cars, and for the accused to pay the girls 12 months salaries or cover expenses related to their repatriation to their home. Enforcement of anti-trafficking persons legislation critical regardless of status. I think I'll admit this. You read the book, let's go to the next. Let's say we have training for skills enhancement and capacity building. There's a picture of people who are going training. And under this one, national training of trainers should be prioritized for one, that which a SADC regional training of trainers for law enforcement officers.
National training of trainers ensure that the training has a wider reach of officers in the countries, and customized country-specific training is delivered. We have also media training on trafficking in persons, and we are saying it is important to raise awareness. Regional training of media practitioners on trafficking in persons was conducted in June 2016. I used to be a lecturer without this thing. Train practitioners to act as resource persons in country training. Media has capacity to reach wide audience and communities in remote and hard to reach places. And it is important for media to clearly define trafficking in persons in comparison with smuggling of migrants and irregular migration. And this was addressed by the PS, that it's very, very important to understand this concept so that appropriate deterrent measures are applied. Skills enhancement and capacity building. Also, we are looking at law enforcement officers trained on trafficking persons in Mozambique. And this training of law enforcement officers and relevant stakeholders training was
in 2015, facilitators drawn from SACPO. I don't know if you know what SACPO is, General DC, IOM, US Embassy. Cooperation between relevant stakeholders and expert organizations is also critical to effective delivery of training.
It's not
but
you are not used to the
microphone. Yeah, I take my hands. I'm fidgety by nature. Facilitators are drawn from SACPO, UNODC, IOM, US Embassy. Namibia, we are looking at training for criminal justice practitioners on trafficking in persons. Training of criminal justice practitioners was conducted in August 2015. It focused on victim centered investigations and prosecutions. In addition, Namibian police has introduced a curriculum on trafficking in persons in its training college. We also have Zimbabwe training of trainers in pressure courses that is critical to trafficking in persons response. Training of trainers for key service providers was conducted in August 2014. Refresher course also conducted in June 2015 collaboration with the listed organizations there. Refresher course also took stock of activities carried out in rolling out the August 2014 training, as well as, and we are saying, refresher course and rolling out of training of trainers to provinces and districts are necessary if the national response is to be implemented comprehensively. Here we are now looking at the other priority areas. We are looking at prevention and public awareness raising, the one that we've been calling for. And here, this was done in Botswana, Setlhogo, go hweba ka batho go a diragala. Se nne motswa setlhabelo, in English meaning, human trafficking is where do not become a victim. Botswana commemorates World Day Against Trafficking Persons, and this commemoration took place in Paragon 2015, organized by Government of Botswana, Service Secretary and UNODC, and the theme was do not become a victim of human trafficking because it's real. Cooperation among countries was highlighted as it is critical to addressing the plight of victims of trafficking persons. Swaziland also had multiple approaches to raising awareness on trafficking persons, including World Day Against Trafficking Persons that was done in 2015, commemorated in an event attended by approximately 3,000 doctors. This is the Prime Minister and Cabinet Minister showing their commitment towards addressing trafficking in persons attended this. Awareness raising initiatives have resulted in an increase in the number of cases reported at police stations and through the road by the toll-free number 975. Cases are referred to the appropriate organizations or departments as guided by detailed referral mechanisms. Very, very important. And we also have door-to-door campaigns that bring trafficking in person issues to the fore in Lesotho. This door-to-door campaign on trafficking in person in Mafeteng and Iria districts was part of Lesotho's 48th independence celebration, and the campaign emphasized the need for cooperation and addressing trafficking in person, as well as local government and traditional leaders involved in the campaign. The campaign reached approximately 1,200 households, and public awareness should go beyond traditional forms to encompass new and innovative ways. Last one is police drama series that is very popular in Botswana, called Tsirelete, which has aired on national TV since 2006. This was in 2016 to raise awareness on trafficking in persons and incorporating trafficking in persons as a component of an already very important for the exit strategy and sustenance program. Reduces cost compared to introducing a new activity. Mozambique raises trafficking persons awareness through song. Stop Trafico Somba, Lisa James tackles trafficking in persons, especially child trafficking. It's a musician. The innocent are at least that protection. There are adults taking advantage of the children. Some are married off without that consent. Music is an effective tool for awareness. That is the message there. Trafficking persons awareness, a permanent feature on the South African calendar. They have National Trafficking Persons Week commemorated annually every first week of October, as well as the week is used also to reinforce awareness around fighting this form of modern day slavery. Activities around the week are coordinated by the National Prosecuting Authority and involve a widespread of activities implemented by several other agencies. Prevention for public awareness also essentials raise awareness on trafficking persons. A two-month media campaign in 2015 raised awareness on trafficking persons, and campaign was titled Open Your Eyes, Bulamaso. Several tools were used, including website, Facebook, poster, and these were used to raise awareness during the period of the campaign. You can see the picture. Victim support and witness protection is another area that was used to share these lessons learned. Swaziland launched trafficking in person victim identification guidelines and referral mechanism. And this victim identification guidelines and referral mechanism for assisting victims of human trafficking was launched by Dr. Sibusiso Dlamini, Prime Minister of Swaziland, in November 2015. Guidelines, key operational tools that we choose. How do you identify a victim of trafficking in persons? How do you look after the victim in a standardized manner? We also have Madagascar Union of Social Workers that was established to support victims of trafficking in persons. The National Union for Social Workers established 2005 has received widespread acclaim for promoting end of child sex tourism and trafficking in persons in Madagascar with the union partners with the government. in implementation of its work, cooperation between state and non-state actors is critical for the successful provision of big team support. We also have SADC, UNODC collaboration. We are talking about headquarters coordination and regional cooperation. SADC, Secretariat and UNODC collaborated to develop a regional traffic investors data collection system. This was meant to facilitate collection management and dissemination of reliable statistics on traffic investment delivery, as well as to provide a regular analytical report on the scope and sense of traffic investments in the region, and also to facilitate information sharing on traffic investment among member states and stakeholders.
1 minute.
Yeah, no, it's the last one. Collaborative efforts in development, let me read the project, that's very important. Cooperation is important if interventions on traffic investments are to yield positive results. We also have collaborative efforts that in the development of policy frameworks in sections with national and regional collaboration resulting in the development of policy measures to prevent and combat traffic investments, as well as training of frontline officers achieved through such cooperation. South Africa, multi-sectoral cooperation, critical development of policy frameworks on traffic investment. And task team also facilitated revival of provincial and district traffic investment response teams. Cooperation key to enhancing response to traffic investments. Read that. Joint permanent commissions critical to peace and security in SADC. Article 2.2G of the SADC Protocol on Politics, Defense Security Cooperation promotes regional coordination and cooperation on security and defense matters. Bilateral alignment on peace and security exists through joint permanent commissions on defense and security at ministerial levels, as well as by national commissions at the heads of state level. We also have SADC countries cooperating to facilitate effective and safe repatriation of survivors of trafficking in persons. Cooperation between SADC member states ensures effective investigation and prosecution of reported cases, as well as to facilitate safe repatriation of survivors to trafficking persons. Cross-border coordination working groups is established in Mozambique and South Africa, and also between Mozambique and Zimbabwe to improve cooperation among key actors for enhanced protection. Zimbabwe also is partnering trafficking persons sensitivity conducting for Zimbabwe Parliament, Italian stakeholder collaboration key to conducting the activity. Some of you can read faster than me now. I have to catch up with time because the research and information sharing is also very critical. The trafficking persons in the region policy brief can also be distributed. Disaggregation and validation of crime data is vital to SADC regional response. We need to know whether it's men or female or transgender or whatever. Research on trafficking persons conducted in 2014-2015 baseline report published in 2016. Disaggregation of statistics on trafficking persons remains a challenge. In some cases, such statistics are collated together with statistics on smuggling of migrants and irregular migrants. I think the emphasis here is that people should understand and these concepts are mutually exclusive, even though sometimes they get confused. There's need for capacity development to differentiate trafficking in person cases from other closely related phenomena. South Africa has a hub for trafficking persons. Understanding the dimension of human trafficking in Southern Africa remains South Africa's most comprehensive study on trafficking. Study also argues that South Africa continues to be a hub as well as a destination for trafficking persons. Serious interventions required to curb this practice.